Wukong made it to Buddhahood, yes. But his gloomy mood never left.
Ha! You two monkeys are identical on this! Shame on you! My keen eye, ford the stream, and you'll surely find something interesting. All hotheads wind up dead!
Easier, you! Where the path narrows, danger lurks.
Huh!
chill. My hide may be thick, but it's no match for this bitter cold. So much for the journey, I guess. Then one day, he dragged me along for a drink. We set out from the west land. Ah! Don't cut me off while I'm speaking!
If you're looking for the temple, just follow me.
For knowledge, I'll take my lumps. Then one day, he dragged me along for a drink. We set out from the west land and worked our way across each of the four lands. From Mount Lingshan to Mount Lojia, the Mount Sumeru, my Mount Fuling, and his Mount Huaguo. That drink did me in good. When I opened my eyes, the three realms were in total disarray. They all said Wukong died and Erlang Shen was the one who murdered him. Hogwash! Who could put an end to Wukong? He must have hidden somewhere to pull a prank on me. Later, an old monkey showed up and told me to throw my support behind a destined one. He said the destined one is supposed to be the key to bringing Wukong back. You! The key! You're no match for even one strand of his hair! I'm wise enough not to believe that Wukong is truly dead. As for what that old monkey had to say, a half-truth at best. But I might as well play along. Just stick by my side and do as I say. I will get to the bottom of what he's cooking up. One way or another. That pavilion looks...
Oi, kid! You look suspicious. What kind of Yao Guai are you?
Shh. I'm looking at that Buddha over there. See his belly button? It's so big. Me and you, we look way smaller.
Buddha? Where is it?
You see no Buddha because you think no Buddha. No thought, no sight.
I, the sacred gourmand, saw enough Buddhas before you were born. Foolish brat. You didn't see that coming, did you?
True hearts find their path, and the Buddha is on that path. Why not worship around with true hearts, for Buddhas may light your path?
Worship my hoof. Visit temples, kneel to figures, tell no black from white. That's my master. I am fed up with all these skin-deep rites.
No true heart, the path is sealed. With true heart, it's revealed. Why the rush? Try looking around. To see a Buddha, one must hold the Buddha in one's heart. Why the rush? Try looking around. To see a Buddha. Why the rush? To see a Buddha.
Ah, I get it now. For Buddhas, that boy said. Ah, there must be four Buddhas to worship. Loony monk. Can't reason with him.
Just go through the motions, boy. Who knows if it's true or not? That little monk was speaking riddles.
Ah!
when we journeyed to the New West. Our master took it from Mount Lingshan. He visited and kneeled to every figure until Yellowbrow captured him. I'm not my master. What's that sound? That little mug's up to his tricks once more! Worship my hoof! Let's go back! Chubby one! We've done the rites! Where's the path?
The path? Isn't it always there?
Don't you trick me, you bald, pot-bellied brat! All I'm seeing are mountains, no path at all!
He sees wisely with faith. You are daft without it.
Cut your nonsense! You must be that trickster himself, fooling us all along! Take my rake!
Why so rude? I didn't force you to kneel! Throwing a tantrum at your age? Shame on you!
You brat! Save your stupid path! I'll borrow one myself! You go on first. I'll meet you at the summit.
One monkey dead, and another shows up.
The face of the distant one. It will fit me just as well.
Yeah! kind sir, pause your steps and heed my story. I was a fox guai who practiced to become one of the humans. One day, I was foraging for food and found myself caught in a hunter's trap. A young scholar saved me and kept me in his home to let me heal. I couldn't move, yet my heart swelled with gratitude. I thought I could aid him in his career in return for saving my life. Little did I foresee that following a dream, he would take my life. My soul lingered, yet he left without a trace. I sought tirelessly, only to find he had become a monk in the new Thunderclap Temple. I beg you, sir, to take my fur and wear my form, comfort him and calm my sorrowful heart. He's hiding in the side hall of the temple. Kind sir, will you lead me to him?
It's freezing here. Fire. I need fire. It's freezing here. Fire. I need fire.
You. Oh, no more frost now.
I heard that Buddha planted watermelons here hundreds of years ago. One bite grants prolonged life. Yet, when the cold bites all around, without your powerful spells, no way I can find it. Someone once saw a chubby boy jump from the cliff with a watermelon in his arms. He rushed to the edge of the cliff but saw no movement down there. Seemed like certain death. But suddenly, he heard the boy laughing from beneath, on and on. Bewildered, he fled from the cliff. This story may offer a clue for my treasure hunt. Maybe the watermelons were planted under the cliff. Don't let me keep you, sir. I will leave by myself when I feel warm enough. This story may offer a clue for my treasure hunt. Maybe the watermelons were planted under the cliff. Don't let me keep... I will leave by myself. This story may of maybe the watermelon. Don't let me keep you. I will leave by myself.
You